boys, girls, and everyone else. Welcome to another episode of Super Mario Galaxy 2. The best Super Mario Galaxy game ever made. Oh, fuck Mario Galaxy 1. That was a joke. I like Mario Galaxy 1. Okay? That was only a joke. Sailing the Sandy Seas. This one's based off of the legendary Sandbird from Sunshine, for sure. Also, look at the skybox here. I can't really look at the camera, but... or look with the camera in first-person view. But the skybox has a bunch of these gigantic towers in it. Oh, hey. Ooh, I can BLJ. No, I really can't, actually. Mm-hmm. 64 was the only game to have that in it. Not even 64DS had BLJs in it. Really not doing so well right now. Maybe if I wasn't an idiot, I would actually be able to do it right. Like I said, I'm an idiot. Hammer, please, don't turn. God damn it, please stop that turning thing. Stop it with that turning shit. Please. Oh. You were supposed to go here. Of course. How could I be so dumb? This is what you came to watch, right? Me just being an idiot at Mario? That's the best thing. Oh, cool. Gravity changes with me. That's pretty neat, how it changes. It's like a Sonic game! You know how you can see, you like spin dash up slopes and stuff, and then the... it's basically like the gravity shifts almost. Or Sonic goes so fast that he's able to maintain his momentum up there. What about here? Oh. Brings you right back up. Fantastic. Like Mario? Are you gonna go here? Not quite. Are you here? Am I actually dumb? Yes, but... well, yes, but actually no. Well, yes, but actually yes. Oh, come on, Mario. Stupid, dumb, fucking plumber asshole cunt. Let's see, what do we do here? I'm gonna think about this a little. Maybe I think I see what we do here. Come down here. Oh, if Mario wasn't a stupid cock head, didn't have an ass-like head. No, you don't do that. Of course not. Why would you do it that way? Why would that be the method of doing these things? Wait a minute. Oh my god, I'm an idiot. Yep, that's how I do it right there. Well. Problem solved. That's pretty cool. Was that just a bonus room? I better not have been. Zoom around the Sandbird Park. Danger, don't fall. Yeah, you think I would know? Since it activates this time. And it gets completely murdered by these cactuses. Those are spawn levels. So yeah, like I said, lots of Mario Sunshine references in this one. Or references to past games in general. I'll take that hit. Evidently these guys can make these platforms disappear. Okay. Motherfucker. Damn it. No, it's speeding up. This is basically the Sandbird, but he doesn't help this time. Oh, whoa. Whoa, then. Oh, buddy, eat a dick. Dude, seriously? Go fuck yourself. Well, probably fast forward time. So I'll be right back. There we go. So that's what happens if you don't mess up like an idiot. Which I'll probably fast forward that, because you probably don't want to sit through the same thing twice. Might as well. Got some coins. Game has been saved again. Which, by the way, thank you for the autosave feature. Whoever decided that was in there. You're a good person. You're a really cool individual. Also, you found a hungry Luna. Oh, you keep telling me about this lava, you fucking motherfucker. I know, I have 1861. I need 1500, right? I'm not sure how this could just automatically happen, but sure. I would prefer that. What is my cat doing? Just... stop that. Oh, it's this fucking galaxy. Well, I wasted my star bits. There's a fleet glide. That's another one of those fluzzard stars, so I just wasted my star bits, but I don't care. I'm not doing that stupid galaxy. Unless I have to. Prince Picante's Paparumu. Shiverburn Galaxy. Yeah, this is the one I've been waiting for. Because this is the one where I show something off. I think I teased this back in my Sunshine playthrough or something. you zoom in, I think, I forget where you can zoom in. Look up there. There they are. Hell Valley Sky Trees. Those alien-looking motherfuckers up there. Yeah, those are better. Those were one of the biggest mysteries, like, as to why were they put there. That's just supported by the creepy-ass music in the background. Gives me the shudders. But, hey, we have a life count of 69, so that's nice. We're gonna ruin the moment, I know, but apparently those things up there, they're huge. But apparently they're terrifyingly huge in size. Yeah, I'll be Luigi now. And then we got another cool, these cool-ass Hellfire Peaks levels. Hellfire Peaks, I said that by accident. That's so cool, that could be an interesting stage. A stage called the Hellfire Peaks? What would that be like? So, this one uses the Cloud Mushroom instead of just the Ice Flower. Last time. And it freezes over. That's fantastic. You waste your claw like that. Also, notice Luigi's skating animation. It makes him look like Shadow the Hedgehog's running animation. Like, every time I think of see someone skating like that, I always think of Shadow's running animation from Sonic Adventure 2. And I'm not sure why. Oh boy. There we go, that's really cool. We got these melons back. The coconuts. From the first galaxy. Comet metal, and get out of here. Because we got a boss to fight after this. Also, was it just me, or when these meteors hit that and it creates the lava? I know it's supposed to look like a barrier of ice, but it just looks like a bowl of hot curry to me or something. But the ice looks like, it looks like a bowl almost of like hot soup. Some shit like that. We're gonna do these guys again. But there's five of them, so it's a little harder. And, you know, just two of them. There goes Gale, Luigi. Oh damn it. I'm screwed. I just wasted half of my health right there. That's great. And it's great because we're gonna do a boss fight now. I'm just calling a sword, we should be fine. This guy's angry. Like every other boss in the game, they get really angry at you. You gotta hit him with the bat, melon, the coconut. It doesn't really piss him off yet, though. Oh boy. He's got a cape on. He's like a king. Well, he's a prince, but... He's gotta be... Wait, is he a prince or is he a... Prince, yeah. That's how you cancel out the skating, you just don't have... There we go. it rains hellfire on us again. We fucking destroy it. Uh-oh. It's kind of cartoony. It explodes. Oh, shit! And it explodes. Yeah. Don't know why I made talk about that so much, but whatever. That's all done with. Maybe I can beat the game tonight. I'll just miss a bit of shift stream. Yes! I saw the movie. Just, yeah. Hell yeah. It's pretty obvious that who's the person who's sending these letters. If you played Galaxy 1, you should know who. Let's see, we leap into action. Okay, catch you later, bro. Shut up, Luigi. I don't know why I'm being such a dick to Luigi, but. You got it. No, I'm not gonna go to the secret star. How many stars do I need to get here? 55. I need two more. Let's see. I think I'll go back and do. One of the stars in the. One of the little extra comet ones. Let's see, we got some extra comets around here. Let's see. Which one should I do? Maybe I'll go to the Dig Dug Galaxy. No, not Dig Dug. Spin Dig. So yeah, we're returning to an early galaxy. That's fantastic. Yes, I know. Pranks are common. Let me... Dig Dug's Daredevil one. Oh, fucking great. A Daredevil one. My favorite. We only need one health for the entire thing. Incredible. Dig Dug's Daredevil one. Fucking amazing. It is just a boss fight though, so it shouldn't be that bad. I don't think I took any damage. I fought it originally. I'm glad they don't waste your time and make you do the actual. Okay, can't take a hit. It's pretty easy to do. Get to hear this amazing, awesome theme again. I feel like. Almost got the son of a bitch. Oh, you son of a bitch, there you go. Oh god damn it. I think the way his AI is scripted. Yeah, so we're gonna beat it. Whatever leg you're closest to, that's the direction he jumps. I don't even know if that's scripted or not, but who even cares? If you're not a programmer, you probably don't even know what scripted means, or in terms of game logic. I mean, you know what the word scripted means, but not like scripting in a game. What am I even talking about? Why do I even mention this? Nikolai's there on the one. So that was pretty interesting. Well, easy, that was easy, that's what I meant to say. It was easy. Let's actually go zoom out again. I'll go do this golden bowl. I'll pick out which star I'll do. Either Prankster Comet or the, depending on which one, Rolling Crab or Romp. Rock and Roll Duel. Which, Thank God in Galaxy 1, you're not forced to be the prankster comet star. Yeah, but I'm doing this because this is a really, really simple, easy extra star. And then I'll go fight Bowser Jr. With Bowser Jr.'s level, I mean, I would do that. Alright then. So now we get here. And I killed him. I didn't barely kill him, I mean. So yeah, there we go. That's all done with. Here's the part I think where we gotta go help some, yeah, this guy over here. Hey, come here. I'll help you. Looking for a star? I won't believe it. I found a star in the trash the other day. Same people just took away. Then we got a trade. I'm really into collecting those Goombas, guys. See? Think you could bring me one? Give me a Goomba, yo. I'm not gonna open that because I'm gonna have my ass out of here. You see, here's a Goomba right here. But the hard, the tricky part about this one is getting him in the mud without getting him squashed like that. Actually, I should probably destroy these with my the rock shroom. I think that's what you do here. I can actually aim it. No, Goomba, don't do this yet. Right. Can you destroy chain shops? You can't. Okay. That's perfectly fine. There's the Goomba right there. Over here, you asshole. Slow down for a second. Okay. He's gotta get him over here. And not squash him, maybe. I wasn't dumb. Or stupid and idiot and stupid and dumb and stupid. Alright, where's the last... Wait, there's something done here? There's the one up here. There's only two. There's only two, that's really dumb. But they're really gonna make me do this. Oh, you probably respawn it, but... Can you? Well, it's fantastic. Oh, oops. Dumb dumb shithead. I don't even care about that. Toads. They're fucking idiots. I would be able to do that if the designers were kind enough to put three of them, but nope, only two. But this is fucking great, isn't it? Now we gotta go back to the map. And load the whole thing again. That's absolutely amazing, isn't it? What was the prankster comet again? Rolling Crabber Bomb. I'll do this instead, because this is really annoying. Maybe. This one's probably an obnoxious too. There's a time limit for this. We had 60 seconds to go in here. And take all these guys out. This is what I remember hating, this star. In particular. This is what made me hate this mushroom power. And then we hit the lock shroom. Because I mean, once you do it, you can't cancel it out. So you can't align yourself better to take these things down. I think I'm okay with this now. Yep, I'm all good. So. Thank God the time limit stops after you get the star spawn. So yeah, that was pretty easy. I don't remember if I had trouble with that or not, but obviously this time I did. And there we go. I'm not wasting my time on that Goomba thing. Toad, I don't care. Shut the hell up, Toad. Alright. Now back to the wall of design. That's what he meant to be going for. Starship Mario can now advance. Bowser Jr.'s Boom Bunker. Bowser Jr. has a bunker, apparently. Bowser Jr.'s Doomsday Machine. I completely forgot. I thought we had to fight... What's it called? Apparently... Fighting... Gobblebutt again. That's just a secret star in a different place. There's a star somewhere else. Oh, we gotta wait. It's broken. There's a bullet bill cannon that's still active, though. What the fuck? Oh, you got a long jump on it. That's right. There we go. There's a cannon here. It's first cannon. It's pretty good. You hit the target here. Thank you for cheering me, Nemo. Cool. Oh yeah, speaking of which, this Hammer Bros and Boomerang Bros were in Galaxy 2, or Galaxy 1. So that's fantastic. Change.
Am I fucking stupid? Am I actually stupid? I did the same thing twice. dear God, I'm pissing myself off at how stupid I am at these Mario games. Right. Okay, now I'll be careful. So this is what happens if you hit it, the Boomer cheers you. Okay, there we go. Good God, that shouldn't have taken me 3 tries to do a simple jump. I don't know how I screwed that up twice. Maybe I really shouldn't be playing Mario games. Yeah, this boss fight's pretty cool. Bowser Jr.'s boom save machine. And then he's gonna be angry if I don't get another grand star. Oh god, is he gonna get beaten? I hope he does, because he's a dickhead. But yeah, this is really one of those first tower machines that you fight. Well, not really, I mean, you fought a few Galaxy Boy. There you go, fucking Bowser Jr. I mean, it's like one of the first ones that's like a genuinely... It's like an actual boss fight. As one of the, main bosses. And he electrifies the top, too. You gotta ground pound it. But then, in one of these bosses do, it rises up and actually starts moving. So yeah, as an actual storyline boss fight, instead of just like a level boss, or like a quote-unquote mini boss, I guess. Like how the one with the Spring Mushroom from Galaxy 1 was Toy Time, that boss. But I hated back in 2018, but found out it really wasn't that bad. But yeah, that boss was cool. It's like a giant tower. And that concept, that won't be the last one in the series. That's like that. Let me do this. Get a cloud in the wind, maybe? Oh, the clouds are gonna disappear. Yeah. But yeah, that boss fight would have a similar one would reappear later. I won't spoil it now, what game it's in, but you could probably guess. The last world open up. We're already in the last world, so maybe I will beat this game tonight. I think I'm actually gonna go do that. That's the 5th grand star I had. I had a feeling you could do it. Next up is that monster's blah 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 blah. I don't care. The big fight awaits. Gerhard was yours, Captain. Alright, Bubba. Sure, buddy. Let's get going. Go to the mist thing. And this world is a really cool background. And let's get him this time. Hell yeah, Bubba. Oh boy. Melty Monster Galaxy, this is cool. Because it has a concept from Super Mario World, but in 3D for the first time. The Magnificent Magnus Sea. Well, this part's really fun. There's a lot of pole stars there. So the pointer better behave. Yeah,
you see those monsters right there? The water monsters? Those are called Blargs. Those were originally from Super Mario World. And this is the first time they're in 3D. But if things had just gone a little differently, then this wouldn't be their first appearance in 3D. You know what would have been? All the way back in Super Mario 64. Yeah, all the way back in SM64. Those things were never supposed to appear. Like, even they're still in the game, actually. Like, their model is in the game. It is coded in there, and it actually exists in there. But they only have one animation, and the behavior is defined, so... If you spawn it in... And the model looks really unfinished anyway, so... They just probably cut the time because of time constraints or something. Oh yeah, speaking of which, this part's really cool with this. Sora takes the poles from Lethal Lava Land. It's really similar because there was a pole jumping section in Lethal Lava Land. Except it was a little bit difficult, more difficult because the pole controls and the aiming wasn't quantized to four directions. Each four side of the pole. But you actually had to aim yourself before. And as you can see, on that section it was lava waves. To my knowledge, this was like the one of the first star or galaxies or whatever levels to have that kind of thing. Oh look, the Mario Copter is back. You watch my Galaxy playthrough, I did a big bit about that in editing. I don't know if I'll do it again, maybe I will. But yeah, those lava waves, they would come back in Mario Odyssey, so that's pretty cool, I guess. So let's see. Schwan. You see the black planets? Those are the ones that the... Right, the darker ones, they... That's where the monsters come through. If you touch them, you get burned, so... Yeah, you don't want to do that. You're on the gray planets. To avoid them. Yeah, that's what happens when you get hit by them. It's not a huge penalty. So you don't want to get damaged. Constantly, because if it happens too much, obviously you lose life. That's how video games work. Thanks for coming to my cat talk, kids. Learning how the basic game mechanics work. Also, it's a huge black hole. Might be the center of the universe after the incident that happened last time. Is this the core of the universe exploded last time? I don't even know what you're doing. Looks like all these additions want to have a word with you, Captain. Why? Making that sound like I'm getting punished or something. How? Mother, why? Yeah, but anyways, this is gonna be, that does it for this episode of Super Mario Galaxy 2. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.